Impressionism began in 1870 to 1900 in France. You're looking at an impressionist painting called Impression Soleil Levant, or Impression Sunrise, by Claude Monet. You may have heard of him. He's probably the most famous of all the French impressionist artists. Les impressionnistes. Les impressionnistes sont fascinés par la lumière, la couleur et la nature. Impressionists are fascinated by light, color, and nature. Quelques impressionnistes, some impressionists. Monet, Van Gogh, pronounced Van Gogh in English. Van Gogh was actually Dutch. However, he spent a great deal of time in France, and so the French sort of claim him as their own. So he's sort of French. Degas, Cézanne, Pissarro, Gauguin, Renoir. L'impressionnisme explore les effets de la lumière et de l'atmosphère sur les couleurs et les formes. Impressionism explores the effects of light and atmosphere on colors and shapes. This is a series of paintings by Claude Monet of haystacks, and he was known for painting the same thing many times in different weather and lighting conditions, different seasons, different times of day. And another thing that's peculiar about Claude Monet is that as his life progressed, his vision deteriorated quite a bit. So some of his later paintings he did when he was nearly blind. And Impressionism is not realism where you the paintings look almost like real life. They give just an impression. So the later on he went in his life, the more you see the paintings are less and less detailed. Les critiques sont choquées par les premières peintures des impressionnistes. The critics are shocked by the first paintings by the impressionists. Mais les artistes gagnent peu à peu l'acceptation du public et aujourd'hui, les peintures sont très populaires. But the artists earn, little by little, the acceptance of the public, and today their paintings are very popular. So when Impressionism first began, this art form of kind of doing the more vague, impressionistic drawing and not as detailed, it was at a time when art critics felt this was not true art. And so, although these paintings and the style of art is today accepted widely and adored, at the time it came out, it was not well received by the public. Claude Monet. Il peint des paysages et des portraits. So Claude Monet is probably the most famous of the Impressionists. He lived from 1840 to 1926. He painted landscapes such as this one I showed you, and also portraits. It's called La Promenade or The Walk. Quand Monet peint des personnes, les visages sont sans beaucoup de détails. When Monet paints people, the faces are without a lot of detail. So something you'll notice in Monet's paintings is that while there may be people in them, You won't see a lot of detail in their faces. Monet fait beaucoup de peinture en plein air. Monet made a lot of paintings outside. Plein air is a term used in English as well. Plein air painting, it means outdoor painting. Il veut capter les vibrations de la lumière sur les objets. He wants or wanted to capture the vibrations of light on objects. Les plus belles représentent son jardin à Giverny. The most beautiful ones represent his garden in Giverny in France. So these are paintings he made in his garden. These are water lilies, and he did a lot of paintings of the water lilies in his garden. This is called the Japanese Bridge. He did quite a few paintings of that. And some of you may have already learned about this in your art class. Pierre Auguste Renoir. Il peint beaucoup de portraits et scènes de la vie et de la société. So Renoir, also a very famous Impressionist painter, he lived from 1841 to 1919. He painted many portraits and scenes of life and of society. Now, compared to Monet, you can really see more detail in the faces of his people. So these are two of his really famous paintings. This one here is called Luncheon of the Boating Party in English. And here are some more of his paintings. And you'll notice he really takes the time to draw the different lighting effects. So you can see the light coming through the trees and it makes dapples or spots. And he made that in his painting. Edgar Degas. Il peint beaucoup de portraits et aussi des sculptures. Il aime beaucoup peindre les danseuses. So Edgar Degas, who lived from 1834 to 1917, he painted a lot of portraits and also he did sculptures. And he really liked to paint dancers. So if you see an Impressionist painting of dancers, it was probably drawn by Degas. And this is an orchestra, but you'll see up here there's some dancers and there's a sculpture that he made of a dancer. Here are some more of his dancers. Les Jardins et la Maison de Claude Monet, Giverny, France. So in 2012, I visited the gardens and house of Claude Monet in Giverny, not too far from Paris, where Claude Monet lived in a number of different places throughout his life, but Giverny is where he did some of his most famous paintings. So here are some of the pictures I took when I was there. And you might notice that they sort of resemble his paintings. So that's his house in the background. There's a close-up of his house. And that's the Japanese bridge that I showed you earlier. So the first is Le Musée de l'Orangerie. Again, this is in Paris. Click this. And now we can explore this museum. We're looking at a beautiful long painting of water lilies. And we can get really close and zoom in. And you can see these different panels. You can zoom out. And just like a typical Impressionist painting, it's really meant to be viewed from a distance. If you get too close, the details become fuzzy. Now, do you remember what the name of the artist is who painted these water lilies? This was Claude Monet. So these are all by Claude Monet. And you'll notice that they are different colors because he painted them at different times of day and also at different stages of his life as his vision deteriorated. So it's interesting to see how he can paint the same scene and make it look different. Some more of these. But these are a little bit different. Still Monet, still water lilies, but they are different colors, different lengths. All right, so we've looked at Monet's water lilies. Now we're going to go to Le Musée d'Orsay, also in Paris. And this is not quite as famous as the Louvre Museum. However, there's a lot more French artwork in the Musée d'Orsay. So I'm going to click here. And so this is the main area when you come in. And you might notice it looks a little peculiar. That's because this used to be a train station. And so they converted it from a train station into a museum. So that's why it looks like a train station. I'm wondering if you can remember who painted this. This was Claude Monet. If you were thinking Claude Monet, you were right. You'll notice that the people in the painting, their faces are not very detailed, which is typical of Claude Monet. Can you guess who made this one? This was also Claude Monet. And again, Claude Monet especially, we see that up close there aren't a lot of details. It's more of an impression of the scene. Going over here, if we look at these ones along the wall here, who do you think painted these? Yes, it was Edgar Degas. He loved to paint dancers. And over here, any guesses on the sculpture? That is also Edgar Degas. He did sculptures. And again, dancer. And into the next room. How about this one right here? That is Renoir. He liked to draw scenes with lots of people in them, and you'll see that they have more detail in their face. Whoops. Then, oh my goodness. Than if you were to look at one of Monet's paintings. Looks like I'm having some technical difficulties here. This is basically the same technology as Google Street View, so sometimes some maneuvering is required. Getting up close there, you can see the details in the faces. Okay, we're gonna go into this next room here. And this next room, and right up here. Any guesses on these? These are also Renoir. Again, portraits. I like to draw couples. And then over here, one last painting. This is Claude Monet. Again, it says wife, and we can barely make out her face.